Assalamu alaikum everyone. Today we are going to unbox an extraction forcep kit that I have ordered, and we are going to learn about the various types of extraction forceps and where to use them, how to use them, and we'll be having a demonstration on a typodont which will be our patient. 6 years ago I had made this video, and then I had little experience on making videos, so hopefully this video is going to be better than the previous one. Let me know in the comment section below if you find the improvement and if you appreciate the hard work behind the video. Let's begin. So here we have the extraction forceps. This is from the brand Waldent. This is the extraction forceps. I ordered this from Dentalkart. We have 12 pieces set here. Everything is mentioned here. It is made up of stainless steel, easy nomenclature for identification, and various benefits and specifications are given here. This is the box. I think we have to open it like this. Yeah, this is the extraction forcep kit. So first, let us understand the basic difference between the maxillary and the mandibular extraction forcep kit, right? So I'm going to pick up two extraction forceps. One is having a different design than the other, right? Okay, so we have these two extraction forceps. I'm going to unwrap it. This is the first time I'm using it. I'm unboxing it in front of the camera. You have to tear it out, I guess. Yes. So here we have two basic forceps. We'll first see the parts of the forcep. We have a beak, we have a hinge, and we have a handle. The same thing goes for every forcep. This is also the beak, the hinge, and the handle. Now, if you see here, the beak is, parallel to the long axis of the handle. But here, the beak is at right angles to the handle. So this one, where the beak is at right angles to the handle, these are the mandibular forceps. So all the mandibular forceps will be having this kind of design, because when you put it like this on the lower arch and try to extract it, this design is helpful. And for the upper one, this design is more ergonomic, more suitable. Okay, so this is the basic difference between the upper and the lower forceps. Now I'm going to quickly unwrap all these forceps so that we can learn about them one by one. So these are the upper forceps and these are the lower forceps. You can see the design difference, the basic design difference that we had seen to differentiate the upper and the lower forceps. And also we have got our typodont, on which we are going to demonstrate how do we extract the tooth, what movements do we make. Okay, so if you see closely at one of these forceps here, the Waldent has mentioned numbering of each forceps, and they have mentioned which forcep is used for what tooth extraction, but there is no need to remember these numbers. You can look at the design of the beaks and you can make out which design is suitable for which tooth extraction, right? Coming first to the maxillary forceps, starting with this one. This, as you can see here, the beak is having little space between them. Okay, this is for the upper anteriors, right? Coming to this one right here, the spacing is almost the same. In my previous video, I had shared a different brand forceps, where the spacing of the anteriors were a little lesser than this. So this is the upper premolar forcep. The curvature is different, right? For this particular brand, they have made the handle design a bit different. So this has a little curvature here, but this is kind of straight. So this helps in the extraction of the upper anteriors, and this is for the upper premolars, okay? Keeping them aside. Here we have molar forceps. We have two molar forceps, one for the right and one for the left side of the quadrant. So how do you identify which type of forcep, which forcep is to be used for which? So for this, we have to look at the beak. Now if you look here, this pointed surface is towards the left side, and here it is towards the right side. Okay, now imagine the patient, the upper arch of the patient. Now, if you have to, you know, do the extraction, this pointed surface, it has to be engaged between the two buccal roots. We know that in the upper molars we have two buccal root and one palatal root. This beak will be engaged between two buccal root, right? So this is for the first quadrant of the patient. Now coming to this one, the pointed beak is on this side, right? So this will engage the two buccal root of the second quadrant of the patient. Okay, so this is for the first quadrant and this is for the second quadrant, right? And these are the molar forceps. Now coming to these two forceps, they look very similar to the molar forceps, but these are the maxillary cowhorn forceps, right? Now cowhorn, you can see the shape of it, and if we compare it with this, you find that we have a little, you know, more convexity here. It is more pointed and this is also very sharp, so it resembles more like a cowhorn. So you can make out the difference between the maxillary molar and the cowhorn forceps. We also have two types of cowhorns. Again, taking the same, you know, example and the vision we had, that this will be engaged between the two buccal roots. So this is the first quadrant and this beak is going to engage the buccal root on the right side, that is the left of the patient. So that is the second quadrant. Okay, now this particular one, this is the third molar forceps. It has a very long beak, as you can see here. So it helps, you know, this kind of design helps in reaching to the most posterior side of the arch, because the mouth opening may be limited. Obviously, it's very difficult to reach third molar. This is our third molar forceps. We have another forceps. This is the root forceps. It has a pointed beak and the beaks are joined together. This helps in the extraction of the root. So these are the maxillary root forceps. So now we have covered the upper forceps. Coming to the mandibular ones, so we will be starting with this particular forceps. This is the lower anterior forceps. So these are, you know, joined together. Little spacing can be there, it depends on various designs. And this is for the lower anteriors. This particular design is for the lower premolar. We have a little more spacing because the width of the tooth, as we go posteriorly, it increases. So the spacing also has to increase. Now this is the molar forceps. You can see we have pointed beaks both sides. Now for the molars, if you remember the anatomy, they have two roots, the mesial and the distal root, right? So it is designed so that it grabs, you know, the space between these two roots on both the sides, okay? Now coming to this forceps, this is the mandibular cowhorn forceps. It is also used for grossly decayed teeth where we have, you know, almost most of the crown lost. So we can grab it via the furcation and extract the tooth. So this is the mandibular cowhorn forceps. And this particular one that we discussed, the maxillary cowhorn, it is also used for the grossly decayed teeth. So that's all about the forceps we are having. We learned about the different designs of forceps, right? Like where to use what. Now how do we use it is the question. So this is our typodont. Okay, first the grasp, you have to make sure, like for this design it is kind of flat, but for these designs you can see that we have a little angulation. Okay, this helps in the grasp of the instrument. Okay, right, so this concavity has to be towards your palm so that you can have a better grip of the instrument. Now coming to the maxillary anterior, right? So for the extraction, you have to grab it like this. So I am a left-handed person, so I'm going to just tell you how do we do it. We give first apical pressure, then buccal lingual, and we rotate it and we take out the tooth. Now coming to this forceps, which is for the premolar, right? So again, we have to do the same thing. We will give first the apical pressure, buccal lingual, and take it out. Okay, now coming to the mandibular forceps, we will be having a look at the beak first and we'll decide which side of the arch it is suitable for, right? So you can see the beak is here, right, on the left side. So if you have a patient and you have to extract a molar on the first quadrant, you'll be using this forceps because, you know, obviously it will be engaging the two buccal roots. Okay, this pointed end will be engaging the two buccal roots and this one will engage, you know, I'll just, I have a little problem using it because it is new. Also, I have a glove that is a little extra large for me, right? So Right. So here you can see this pointed end, it is going to fit between the two buccal root, and this side it is going to embrace the palatal root, and we will be extracting it. We'll give buccal pressure, lingual pressure, and then take it out with a little more buccal pressure, right? We're not giving rotation in this case. This is again a maxillary molar forcep. Again, we have a beak on the opposite side, so this is suitable for the second quadrant, that is the left side of the patient. Right, so we see that this pointed tip will be between the two buccal root, and this beak will be embracing the palatal root, and then we give buccal lingual pressure, you know, and then give a little more buccal pressure and take it out. This is the third molar forcep. So this design, this long beak helps in the removal of the third molar, which is very far away. Then this particular one is the root forcep, okay? Now coming to the mandibular, this was our mandibular anterior forcep. So this is how we will give a apical pressure, buccal lingual, rotate and take it out. For the premolar, based on the beak design, the same principle will apply here. This is for the molar. So for the molar, you remember we have two roots. One is this mesial, one is this distal. So we're going to engage it between, you know, two roots, first giving apical pressure, buccal, lingual, buccal, and take it out, right? And this is the cowhorn, which engages the furcation area, which we have already discussed, right? So this was about the extraction forceps. We discussed about the maxillary and the mandibular, and we have also seen a little demonstration on how to use it. I hope you found this video helpful. I ordered this kit from Dentalkart, and the service was really good. So I would recommend that if you're looking for any kind of products, you can visit their website and have a look at them. So thanks for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. Let me know in the comment section below. And if you want me to make any other demonstration video, let me know. I'll be happy to make it. Thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.